Hello and welcome to free classes. So in this lecture of science series, we'll move next towards health and diseases. So very first of all, we'll see what is meant by health. So health is a stage of complete physical, mental and social well-beingness, not merely that absence or any kind of a disease. So this is a prominent definition we have about health. Now let's look into the disease. Disease is a condition of a disturbance in psychological or physiological process of a body. Okay, so this is a definition regarding disease we have. Now further, diseases are classified into the pattern. So let's look into it. So diseases are first divided into according to duration time. It could be some chronic disease also, some acute diseases also. Further, these are divided into according to reason pattern. It may be hereditary from one generation to another generation. Okay, example we have, that is Down syndrome. It may be some acquired disease. It could be like infectious, non-infectious, like a common cold, flu, dengue. In this non-infectious disease, we have some diabetes, heart disease and all. Now, next, so let's look into the some infectious disease. So very first of all, we have this table. In this column, we have some name of a disease, the pathogen which caused it, mode of infection we have, and some prominent symptoms and how you can prevent or treat that disease. So here, so very first of all, we'll see this tuberculosis. Okay, so Mycobacterium tuberculi is a pathogen for it. Mode of infection, like this spitting by patient through air, prolonged contact with this person. Okay, so these are some symptoms like a chronic cough, bloody spitting, emaciation, difficulty in breathing. So these are some treatment criteria we have. BCG vaccine. Okay, so you can also isolate that patient. Okay, so maintaining distance from these patients will not able to spread the disease. Now next we have, that is a hepatitis. So hepatitis is a further converted into the types hepatitis A, B, C, D and E. Okay, the mode of infection will be contaminated water sharing. Okay, sorry, contaminated water, sharing of needles, blood transfusions. Okay, now symptoms like we have some yellow urinate, general weakness, nausea, vomiting, gray stool. Okay, the overall, I mean, if not feeling well, like in the process of this weakness. So we have some prevention, that is you can you can boil your drinking water, proper cleaning of your hand, that is the most essential thing we have. Now so these are some major these are some example of them, you can go through by it. So next, that is the most important topic we have, that diseases of this present days. So very first of all, let's look into the dengue. So it is caused by a mosquito that lay eggs in a water locked places, thereby their population increases. So if you have these water locked places like these tires and other stuffs, so please clean them. Now different species of mosquitoes are spread different diseases. Dengue is spread by Aedes aegypti. This disease is caused by DEN1-4 virus belong to the type flavivirus. Now we have some symptoms of them, like we have if you feel acute fever and headache, condition like vomiting, pain in the eye socket is a very prominent symptom. Okay, so be careful of it. So decrease in a platelet count that may lead to internal hemorrhage. Next, so next disease we have, that is a swine flu. Okay, so these are some reason on infection. Infection for swine flu occurs through the pigs to humans. Okay, viruses of a swine flu are spread through secretion of nose, throat and saliva. Okay, so these are some symptoms of swine flu, that is if you feel difficulty in breathing. Okay, you have sore throat, a body pain, like this. So we have, for diagnosis of a swine flu, we have liquid from throat of patient is sent to the laboratory diagnosis, and now we have this institute that is National Institute of Virology, Pune based. Next, so this is the information regarding swine flu, that first case of swine flu was reported in Mexico in 2009. So swine flu is caused by the virus this H1N1, and person who come in contact with the pigs can contract that disease, and the one who comes with the condition with these things, it can spread vigorously. Now the next thing we have, that is acquired immunodeficiency syndrome known as AIDS. So this is caused by HIV virus, that is human immunodeficiency virus. Okay, now in this disease, victims suffer from various diseases due to progressive weakening of natural immunity. Okay, this is the most important part we have. Diagnosis of AIDS cannot be confirmed without test in a medical laboratory. So Government of India and many other institutes have developed this ELISA test. Okay, that is purely for this AIDS. Now, so always remember, AIDS do not occur due to touching and sharing the food of this HIV infected and many other things. So our behavior with this patient must be normal. Okay, now, so infection through animal, in this part we'll see infection through this animal, we'll see now the first disease, that is rabies here. So in this criteria, it is a viral disease. First of all, it occurs due to the bite of infected dog, rabbit, monkey, cat and many other animals. Viruses enter the brain via neuron. Hydrophobia is one of the important symptoms of the disease. In this case, victim shows extreme fear of water. Okay, the victim who catches these viruses of rabies shows the extreme fear for water. Rabies is a fatal disease. Okay, so however, fatality can be prevented. Okay, by timely vaccinated before onset of a symptom. Okay, so symptoms start to appear within 90 to 175 days of a dog bite. So you must be careful. So here are the symptoms of rabies. So fever for 2 to 12 weeks. So long lasting fever if you have a continuous fever. Exaggeration in the behavior. Hydrophobia if you are getting fear from the water. Okay, it could be the condition for the rabies now. So in this next type, we'll see non-infectious disease. So diseases which do not occur through infectious and body contacts are called non-infectious. So what is the keyword we have? That do not occur through infection or body contacts. So that is the reason they are known as a non-infectious disease. Okay, so very first in this segment, we have cancer. That is uncontrolled abnormal cell growth is known as a cancer, or a group or lump of cancerous cell is called malignant tumor. So cancer can occur in a various organ like lung, mouth, tongue, stomach, breast, uterus, skin and many other things here. So these are some reasons of the things like consumption of tobacco, gutka, smoking, alcohol, lack of fiber content, fruit, vegetables, things in your food, excessive consumption of a junk food. Okay, so like pizza, burger we have. So these are some reasons of it. Okay, it could be heredity. Okay, like from transferring from one generation to another generation. So these are some symptoms of it. That is a chronic cough, hoarse voice, difficulty in swallowing, incurable scar, inflammation like lump in breast, unexplained weight loss. So these are some symptoms of this cancer treatment. Now in the next criteria, we have diabetes. So the hormone insulin, okay, the name of hormone is what? Insulin is produced in a pancreas. Okay, let me show you clearly. So here the hormone insulin is produced in the pancreas in the body that control the level of sugar glucose in a blood. So if insulin is secreted in a low quantity, glucose level cannot be controlled. So that is the reason this disorder is known as a diabetes. Now, symptoms which cannot be ignored. Okay, so it could be like frequent urination at night. Okay, increase obesity or weight loss. This could be some major important statement. So you should not ignore them. Now, reason for the diabetes is heredity. This is the most prominent reason. Okay, more than 95% the diabetes is caused by the heredity, obesity, lack of physical exercise, mental stress. Okay, so this could be some prominent reason for diabetes. Now, here we have some preventive measure for it. Okay, so follow a proper diet. Okay, you should be taking balanced meal always, medicines, exercise under supervision of this doctor, and these things. So in this criteria, next we have that is a heart disease. So efficiency of the heart disease due to decreased blood supply. Okay, so the reason, prominent reason, is that decrease of a blood supply and thereby oxygen and nutrient supply to the heart of muscle. So due to this, heart has to perform work. Now, so due to this, heart has to perform more work that leads to stress on it. Okay, and this may cause you heart attack. Okay, if someone has a heart attack, immediate consultation of doctor and treatment necessary. Okay, now one should not ignore this symptom. Okay, so this could be some symptom for heart attack. So severe chest pain, pain in the shoulder, neck, arms, cramp in hand, uneasiness if you are feeling not good, tremor are like this. So these are reasons for heart attack. So we'll see one by one them. So smoking, alcoholism, diabetes, hypertension, obesity, lack of physical exercise, heredity. Okay, so these are some reasons behind heart attack. Now, so to prevent this heart attack, you must do regular physical exercise and all the things. Okay, so heart diseases are now, these are the things, medical science, we have so progressive here. So heart disease so if you go by these heart attack problems, so you can perform this angioplasty, next could be some bypass surgery, open heart surgery, and if it major happens, so heart transplantation we have, okay, installation of a stent, installation of a pacemaker, and many other things. Now, so now we'll see some misuse of a medicine. Okay, so sometimes some people take the medicine without prescription. Okay, and that is not at all good. So overdose of medicine may affect your body. Okay, so suppose overdose of painkillers may damage your nerve systems, excretory systems, liver. Overdose of antibiotics may lead to nausea, stomach ache, dysentery, rash, white patches on tongue. So these are some things. Now, in this criteria, we have new topic, that is a generic medicine. Okay, so generic medicines are also known as general medicine. Okay, these are some manufactured and distributed without any patent. Okay, so these medicines are at a par quality with branded medicine. Okay, so you have some generic medicine here. Okay, you have some branded medicine. Okay, the cost will be so much low of this generic medicine as compared to this branded medicine. So these are some lifestyle and diseases and how they are correlated to each other. So lifestyle include daily routine and type of food. Okay, these are the most effective things we have. Nowadays, habits like staying in a bed till late in the morning, going bed late in the night, frequent changes in the meal time, lack of physical exercise, okay, consumption of over junk food. So these are all the reasons. Okay, so you must take care of your body also. If frequency of becoming sick is to be lowered, people should follow right lifestyle. Okay, so you must go for your physical exercise, yoga, and all the things. Now, So pranayam yogasan should be performed under the expert supervision. Now next we have, that is vaccination. Okay, vaccination is important to prevent the infectious disease. Okay, so here is a general information for the students, that is Government of India declared the Pradhan Mantri Jan Aushadhi Yojana on 1st July 2015. Okay, in this scheme, a best quality of medicine are made available at a very affordable price. So, Jan Aushadhi stores are launched for this purpose. So, in your city, you have this Jan Aushadhi store. So, you must purchase from this store only. Now, so these are some data for the awareness, that is health awareness. So 7th April is celebrated as a World Health Day, whereas 29th September is a World Heart Day. Now 14th June is a World Blood Donation Day and 14th November is a World Diabetes Day. So this is a box which gives you the importance of a blood donation. Okay, so one unit blood donated by a person can fulfill the need of three person at a time. So for example, RBC, WBC and platelets. Okay, so these are three things. So one can save three next lives. Okay, so you must donate your blood regularly. Okay, so that is all for the today. Thank you, and thank you very much. If you like the lecture, please subscribe.